Hi, good morning, everyone. Sorry for this delay, little delay. There was a technical hitch, and that's the reason why it was delayed. Can we unmute all? Can we unmute all? I mean, mute all. Can we mute all, Vinay?
Yeah.
Okay. This webinar is about EDAT or MIT DAT, which we are conducting on 9th of May. This is the reason why we are here, and I am addressing all of you. Myself, Professor Anant Chakradev. I'm Dean Faculty of Design, MIT Institute of Design. The purpose, as you know, why we are shifting from a pen and paper test to a test which is done online. Due to present situation because of COVID-19, there is a chance that the current lockdown will be extended further. And there is a chance that even if the lockdown is extended further, there will be certain restrictions on travel. There will be restrictions on allowing many people to come at one spot, that is restrictions on gathering. So in view of this, it seems to be this year to conduct the pen and paper design aptitude test, which we are conducting, which we used to conduct for all these years. Because of the same reasons, it is also difficult. It is also difficult to, conduct the studio tests and interviews, which was very important part of the entire selection process for MIT Institute of Design up till now. But as we are completely unsure about the situation which is unfolding in front of us, I think we'll have to change the process, and that's the reason why we have taken the decision to change the admission process this time. So I'll start this webinar. We have around 1 hour for the webinar. So I'll quickly tell you about MIT Group and MIT ID in about 2-3 minutes. Then I'll brief you about the entire schedule which we are going to follow in this EDAT or in this entire admission process. I'll cover most of the points like nature of the test, the nature of the problem solving questions, timelines, post the results, then instruction about many other things, whether there will be mock test or not, studio test, this, that. So I'll cover almost all aspects of this entire admission process. So I'll request you to be there till end so that you don't miss anything. About MIT Group, as you are aware, we run 4 universities. We run many other colleges, like we have 2 medical colleges, then engineering colleges, schools, few other institutes. At present, we run 4 universities as a group. MIT World Peace University, which is our city campus, Kothrud campus in Pune. MIT Art, Design and Technology University at Loni in Pune, where MIT Institute of Design is located. This is second university. Third university is in Ujjain, which is Avantika University. That is our own university run by MIT Group. And fourth university is at Shillong, which is MIT University Shillong. So we've done 4 universities. Out of these 4 universities, 3 universities have design programs. So MIT Institute of Design is one of the front runners out of that. We started our operations in 2006. So it is a 14-year-old design institute and one of the sought after design institutes in the country. Second design program is at Avantika University, Ujjain. That is also equally good. They are in 4th year of operation and they are doing well. So that is another option you have under MIT Group. Third option is MIT World Peace University, that is at Pune, Kothrud campus, which is our city campus, which is prominently known for our engineering and management programs, but that campus has also started design program 2 years back. So under MIT Group, you have three options, but out of those three options, this entire exercise is being done for two options. That is MIT Institute of Design and Avantika University. So whatever we are doing, whatever EDAT or DAT is being conducted, it's for these two design programs, one at LONI, which is MIT Institute of Design, popularly known as MIT ID, and second is at Ujjain, which is Avantika University. MIT WPU, which is World Peace University, they have their separate admission process for design also. So you'll have to contact MIT WPU for their admission process separately. But for Avantika University and for MIT Institute of Design, this is the process which we are running. I hope I have made a few things very clear at the start of the webinar itself. So let me go to next point, which is the entire schedule or the entire program which will be there under this admission process. So let me present to you so this is the admission booklet, right? All right, so this is how we will be conducting the entire admission process. And this process, as it is written here very clearly, is for MIT ID and Avantika University. My request is, because I have gone through the questions, and my understanding is many people have not read this booklet properly. So everybody has received this mail. Everybody has received this mail. If you have not received, this is available on our website also. Please go through this mail or this Word document properly so that you will get answers to all your questions. But still, at the say risk of repeating the things, I'm repeating it here. So as I said, the admission process will be in three stages. One, the stage one is MIT EDAT, which will be online design aptitude test on 9th of May. Second is as the problem solving. I mean, you are supposed to solve two questions at UG level and one or two questions at master's level on the same date, which is solving the problem solving questions, right? Problem solving assignments. So the EDAT will be there on 9th from 10 to 11:30. After EDAT is over, you will get, you can start your assignments towards problem solving. For that, you are supposed to be taking 2 hours. So around 11:30 to 1:30, you can solve those problems. And you are supposed to upload those problems separately on the link which will be provided to you via mail. Now, EDAT is conducted by external agency. So once EDAT is over, once all the questions are solved, and once you say submit, the EDAT part will be automatically closed. At the same time, you'll have to open your email, registered email, which you have given to us. You'll have to check the questions for you in that mail. So open your email once your EDAT is over. See the questions which are supposed to be solved on the same day, that is 11:30 to 1:30 on 9th of May. So those questions are to be solved on offline basis. You'll get 2 hours to solve those questions. A4 sheet is to be used for, so one A4 sheet is to be used for one question. Like that, you will have two A4 sheets for two questions. If it is one question, it is one A4 sheet. Once you solve those questions, you'll have to upload those questions on the link which is provided in your mail. So that is second part of the testing procedure or admission procedure. So first part is EDAT. Second part is solving the design inclination assignments or problem solving questions. Third part, which will be portfolio review, for which Almost every one of you have already sent the portfolios to us on the given link. We have received all the portfolios. For UG, those who have not sent the portfolios up till now, we'll give them another 2-3 days, but after that we'll not accept the portfolios and you'll be completely out of the process, because we'll not even if you give EDAT, we'll not consider it. So third part is portfolio review and grading. So whatever portfolios we are receiving, we'll review them, we'll grade them, we'll mark them. And weightages wise, MIT EDAT has 50% weightage, but most important part is it is a qualifying test. So MIT EDAT has 50% weightage. The problem solving questions or problem solving assignments has 25% weightage, and portfolio has 25% weightage. So we'll add all these things together and prepare the final merit list, and accordingly we'll go ahead. So this is what we will do for admissions to MIT Institute of Design this year. Those who are interested in Avantika, or those who don't get admission to MIT Institute of Design and are trying for Avantika option, for them, till declaration of EDAT result, the process will remain same. So EDAT result will be declared. Till that point, the process remains same. After that, MIT Institute of Design process is different. The Avantika process is different. You might get calls or mails from both the institute. It is up to you whether you want to respond it or not. That is completely your call. So for MIT EDAT, as I said, it is a qualifying test. That's why it is very important. Candidate, it is a proctored test. So candidate is not supposed to go anywhere at any center. Candidates are not supposed to assemble at one point in coaching class or somewhere else, will cancel those performances. So candidate is supposed to give his or her test from their stay, from their residence. That is the mandatory condition. The test is for 1 hour, 30 minutes. There will be 50 questions of 1 mark each, 50 questions of 1 mark each, and there is no negative marking. Once again, I'll repeat, there will be 50 questions of 1 mark each. There is no negative marking, and the time duration is 1.5 hours. So this is about EDAT. The important question was about what will be asked in EDAT. So there will be questions about design inclination. There will be questions about analytical and logical thinking. There will be questions about communication skills and personality trends. Those who have given some other exams like NID or UCID, I think it will be more or less similar to how the questions are set. But these are the major areas, or these are the overall areas on which the questions will be set for EDAT. So design inclination, analytical and logical thinking, communication skills, and personality trends. This is what we will cover. When I say it is a proctored test, there are many restrictions. I mean, the first and most important thing is you must have a computer or a laptop which has a live camera connected to it. That is the important test to, that is the important condition to give this test. When we say camera, that means you will be monitored very closely, as it is a proctored test. There are AI, artificial intelligence measures in the tool which we are using for this test. So any malpractice which is happening around or at the time of test will be recorded. And if we see any malpractice at the same time, at that particular instance is itself, for the test for that particular candidate will be stopped. So the candidate will not be allowed to give that test further. For example, if you are giving the test sitting in a chair, and if you are not seen in that chair for some time, that means you have gone somewhere. So that means test will be discontinued. Or if there is a movement seen behind you, or if we see some people interacting with you, or some noise coming, or mobile use of mobile is happening, or so some other things which are happening, which are detected by the cameras, we will immediately stop that test. And this is automated process. There are, like in normal exam, there are invigilators. There will be hundreds observers from the service provider and from our side. And whenever we feel that there is something happening which is not right, we will immediately discontinue the test. At the same time, you can use a paper and a pencil or paper and a pen besides your computer to solve those questions. So that is allowed. You should not use any calculator. You should not use any any mobile. There is a calculator available in the screen of the test itself. So there is a calculator available on the computer which you are solving the test within the display of the test. So you should use that calculator. You can use pen and paper for solving, for doing rough work, that is allowed. But beyond that, nothing is allowed. Please remember all these things. So there will be sets of question papers. So some students might receive one set, some students might receive the other set. We have weighed these sets very carefully in terms of difficulty level. So both the sets are equal, same within the set. So you might receive set one, and within the set, the jumbling of questions will be there. I mean, the order of the questions will be changed. So for me, it can be question number one, something. For someone else, the same question will be at 10th place or maybe at 49th place. So jumbling of question papers along with jumbling of questions is a part of this test. Most important is you will be given time to set all these things. So day, test day minus four or test day minus five, you will get an opportunity to launch that launcher, download all those things, be ready for the test and give a mock test, check the system, check everything. So that might happen. So you'll receive a separate mail for that. But what we are planning is that will be tentatively done on 5th or 6th. Most important thing, till we complete the admission process, please visit your mailbox on regular basis. You'll be getting mails about many instructions. Please receive, please see your mailbox on regular basis. That is very important because otherwise you may miss some important information. Please don't do that. So on 5th or 6th, there will be registration. Separate registration for test is required. It is not registration about design aptitude test. It is registration to the system which we are using to conduct the online test. So there will be registration, there will be launching and downloading and all those things will happen, and there will be mock tests. So those who want to take up that mock test, they can take up that mock test. That is how you can go ahead with this. The system requirements are mentioned in your mail. Please go through the mail. This same document is available on our website also. They have very clearly written what are the requirements. Please see that those requirements are there. If you don't have, please borrow it from someone because it's an important activity. I'm sure your friends, your family members, your relatives might have a laptop with camera. Please borrow it for, say, 1 week time. And that will help you in giving this test. Most of the students might have it, but those who don't have, please borrow it at least for 1 week. We are doing it because we are compelled to do it. Please try to understand. We would have been very happy to support you and to take pen and paper tests and to conduct the interviews and to conduct all other things. But I suppose we will not be able to do that because of the current situation about COVID-19. And we are supposed to find out new ways of doing same things without compromising the quality of the admission process. So that's what we are doing. Please go through these requirements. It supports Windows, it supports Ubuntu, it doesn't support Mac, but at present I'm on Mac. I can show you if you want. So I have a thing called as Parallel Desktop. So if you download this Parallel Desktop, it is a free trial version for 1 week. You can download, you can install, you can install Windows on that. And that is how you can still use your Mac machines for giving this test. It is not mentioned in the document because it's like, I found it on my own. I Googled like how to use Windows on Mac machines, and it gave me this option. And when I used this option, I did a trial also, it worked. So I was able to give test. We did a mock test by using this. So those who have Mac, please, you can try this. Otherwise, please borrow a laptop or a desktop which has which supports the browsers which are mentioned. So this is about the EDAT. About appearing for EDAT, I think you'll get a link. You'll get you'll get a link in which all the things will be mentioned properly. Then you'll have to take mock test and then be ready for the final test. Now, once the final test is there, once the final test is done, you'll have to submit those answers. Please, please, please. Check it twice, thrice, whether you have submitted those answers, because it might happen. It happens in CET, it happens in JEE. I come across many candidates who say we have given the test, but we did not submit. So please submit it carefully. Please check it twice before submitting. And once you submit, I think the browser will close, the window will close, the test will be over. Then go to your mailbox. You will receive a mail. Check that mail. There will be questions, there will be assignments for you to solve in offline mode, and you start solving. Suppose someone completes, it's 10 to 11:30. Suppose someone completes the EDAT in 1 hour, fine, wait for some time, take some rest, and at 11:30 you can start this new test. There will be two questions. Problem solving assignments will be two. The nature of the problem solving assignment will be in a general nature for undergraduate. Problems are problems. We can see problems everywhere. Even COVID-19 itself is a problem. So we can see problems everywhere. So very general problem solving questions will be asked, through which we want to test design inclination or creative quotient which you people have, and that's what we want to check. But no need to study specific area, or let's say some UG student will say, I want to join product design afterwards, so should I focus on product design problem solving? Don't do that. For undergraduate students, for BDES, the problem nature of the problem solving questions is very general, very generic. For master students, please see that those problems will be specific to the discipline for which you have applied. So for BDES, you need not worry. It will be very generic problem solving question. For master students, it will be very discipline specific problem solving question. So 2 hours are given for that. And please upload a scanned copy. While scanning, if you have a good camera, fine. Otherwise, you can take a photograph with cam scanner. That's the reason why, which is there in your mobile. That's the reason why we have kept A4 sheet, so that a good photograph can be there. You can click 3-4 photographs, and the best can be sent to us. You upload it properly on the link which is given, and then you need not be worried about that. So problem solving is second stage of the entire thing. Most important part for this is, as I said, as the first line of EDAT says, this will be the qualifying test for second round. So what we are going to do is we are going to shortlist maybe some students for second round. For example, these are just tentative numbers for your idea. We may shortlist around 800 students for second round of BDES program, non-fashion. So BDES, non-fashion programs, 800 students can be shortlisted. These are tentative numbers. The numbers can change here and there a bit. Around 300 students will be shortlisted for fashion design program, BDES. So BDES non-fashion, around 800 students. BDES, BDES fashion design, around 300 students we will shortlist. And for master's program, around 350 students in total. Means we have around 13 disciplines. So we'll shortlist around 350 students for second round at master program. So let's say 800 plus 300 plus 350, around 1450 to 1500, 1500 students will be shortlisted for second round. Now, once we shortlist, let's say 1500 students for second round, what we will do is we will take their portfolios only, we will take their assignments only, and we'll check those 1500 assignments. There is no point in checking thousands of assignments when they are not shortlisted. So the most important part is EDAT, which is a qualifying test. So once you qualify, then we already have your assignments with us. We already have portfolios with us. We'll take out those portfolios, we'll take out those assignments, and we'll assess only those assignments. This is for MIT Institute of Design. So on 9th, we will have this EDAT as well as assignments test. 10th is a buffer because we will receive raw data from the service provider. And raw data is just marks. We are supposed to put it in our format, which is reservation format, which is quota format. So for MIT Institute of Design, there is 70% Maharashtra state quota, 30% out of Maharashtra state quota. Within 70% Maharashtra state quota, there is a reservation as per Maharashtra government norms. So we'll have to put, categorize all these students into their respective categories, and then go for final result, and then take out around 800 students per second round. So we'll require one day for this. That's why the result of EDAT will happen on 11th of May. So 9th of May is the test, EDAT as well as problem solving questions. 11th of May is your result. So by afternoon on 11th of May, the result of EDAT will be there. You are not supposed to do anything after that because we will be fetching those portfolios and the problem solving assignments for those selected students, and we'll start assessing those assignments. So we'll require around 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, then 16, 5 to 6 days to view your portfolios of shortlisted students, view the assignments which you have solved and correct those and give marks to those assignments and be ready with the result. So most probably on 17th, we'll declare the first list for undergrad, that is BDES, first list for BDES fashion, and first list for all master's programs which we are running. So final result is expected on 17th. Now you will understand why we have asked you to send portfolios in advance, or we are asking all of you to solve those questions so that we'll have the data, we'll have the assignments with us, and it will be easy for us to give the result as quickly as possible. If we would have waited for result and then we would have asked for portfolio, we would have given, then it would have taken another 15, 20 days. We wanted to avoid that. And that's the reason why we have asked all these things in advance. So on 17th, the result, final result will be out. First list will be out and you'll be given 8 days to pay the fees. For that also, don't worry, you'll get a separate mail. Once you go to the website, enter your number and see the result. If the result says, yes, you are shortlisted for second round, on 17th, if the result says that you are selected for MIT Institute of Design, then you'll get a mail, detailed mail on your registered mail ID. And that mail will have all the schedules, all the fee details, all the refund details mentioned in that. While paying the fees, my suggestion is please go through the refund rules which we have mentioned. Refund rules are same. We have already mentioned it on our website. Even today you can go through refund rules. But before paying the fees, my suggestion is please go through the refund rule. There might be changes in dates, because our standard refund rules have some one month type of thing. We might be little liberal this time because we understand the difficulties through which all the people are going through. So we might be a little liberal in terms of duration and in terms of the dates, but please see that mail very carefully. Please see the refund rules very carefully before paying the fees. So this is the overall schedule. So once again, in short, I'll repeat, 9th of May, EDAT, 10 to 11:30. 9th of May, problem solving questions, offline mode, 11:30 to 1:30. You are supposed to upload same questions from 1:30 to 2:30. We have created sufficient bandwidth, don't worry. While giving the test, if you come across any problem, there are helpline numbers. You'll get those numbers. You'll have to contact those helpline people. We'll see what to do, how to correct that. For problem solving assignments, if you get any issue while uploading, please contact us. We'll take care of that. For problem solving assignments, please contact MIT ID admission line number. For EDAT, please contact the helpline, which is created by service provider. So these are the two numbers. You'll get all these things in details. Don't worry. Please see your mail. Portfolio review, as I said, it will be done. So this is what we are doing in short. So EDAT 9th, then 10th. So I won't repeat this. This is available on the website also. Please go through it. You will get sufficient time to pay the fees. The payment mode will be only through electronic transfer. This time we may not even accept checks and DDs. Checks we don't accept anyway, but DDs we may not accept because you may not get time. Banks may not be cooperative in giving DD. So the best way will be transfer online. That will be the best way. If someone doesn't have that facility, then we will accept DD. But for that, you'll have to go to the bank and draw the DD and send it by courier to us. All those details will be there in the mail which you get. So we'll mention about it. Don't worry. We'll cooperate on those issues. We are not like any other institutes who are saying that pay the fees, pay the fees, pay the fees, and will not return it back, something like that. So we will be very much liberal. We are a very responsible university. We are a very responsible institute. So this is what I wanted to brief you about the schedule. I think you must have gone through the other document, which is there, but if not, please go through the other document, which is very important, which is instruction sheet for MIT EDAT. And whatever we have discussed up till now, is mentioned in this. You'll get this document very shortly. So they have mentioned what type of system is and how this surveillance will happen and how you'll be monitored and all those things. So please, go through this document. There is another document which you'll get, which is about this is for your example. There is nothing to hide. It will be conducted by TCS, who are TCS Ion, who are known for conducting JEs and NATAs and USITs. And the only difference was they used to conduct it at their center. Now we are conducting it as a proctored test. That is the only difference. So same TCS Ion is conducting this. So be assured that it is a very foolproof system which they have created. Now this document you'll get. This has very clear instructions about how to download the software, how to download that application, what type of systems are required, how to register, then how to be ready for the test, what is the launcher, what is that software, then what is the screen, that test screen, how to answer the questions. All these things are very clearly and in detail mentioned in this document. So please go through this document. I did it on my own, on my laptop, it worked. So I'm sure there will not be problem for you also to, understand this and be ready for the test. So these documents will be sent to you before 4th or before 5th and 6th, because on 5th and 6th, you are supposed to, do all these exercises and be ready with the mock test. And after giving mock test, be ready with the final EDAT. So I think we have, taken proper care about all the things, and we have not compromised on quality of selection process. That's what I wanted to say. Now, let me check whether I have not covered anything. I know there are questions. I have received the questions, so I'll go through the questions. Don't worry about that. But other than that, I'll check whether I have missed out something or what. So this is what I wanted to brief you. Once again, I'll repeat. Please read all the mails carefully. Please read all the documentations carefully, because that is how we all will be able to handle this entire thing. Let me check which document I was referring to, because if not, I'll open the same document. Okay, fine. All right, so there are names, but not an issue, but I'll focus on questions. All right, so I'll focus on questions. Yeah, so I'll not go through any question which is related to MIT ID and which courses do you run. And for that, you'll have to visit the website. I am sure when you have applied, you have visited. If not, that you'll have to go through our website once again. So what will be the paper pattern of the design aptitude test and online assignments? I said I have explained it very clearly. For UG, it will be based on 3-4 categories, which are mentioned in the document. Please go through that document carefully. And for PG, it will be discipline specific. Design aptitude test will be same. Almost same for UG and PG. There will be different questions, but it will be more or less same. So please treat it as design aptitude test. It is for checking aptitude test, and it is multiple choice question type of test. About bandwidth and all other things, I'm sure you'll have to get someone for your help. Please borrow it if you don't have. Seeing such conditions in Maharashtra, this is a very important question, I suppose. Hello, sir. Seeing such conditions in Maharashtra, where has it gone? Admission. In Maharashtra, if unfortunately the lockdown extends till next year, for God's sake, please don't say this, but it's not in our hand. But yes, we are prepared for that. If the lockdown is extended further, we will continue online mode. We will start the institute in online mode. And whenever government allows us to have students on the campus, we'll give sufficient time to students to come on the campus. At present, UGC has given clear instructions that all new programs, the freshers should join on 1st of September. So I think we have sufficient time, and by September, this all pandemic or this all COVID-19 issues will be over, and we'll be able to meet each other, and students will be able to join. We will have to take extra precaution because we have hostels. All of our students stay in the hostel, so we'll be very careful. But don't worry, we will start the programs on 1st of September, either in online mode or I hope we'll start the programs in person, in physical mode, because by 1st of September, it will be over. So we will be starting our second year, third year, fourth year as per UGC guidelines on 1st of August, and we'll be starting our new year on 1st of September. So please be assured, don't worry. I have a Mac. Somebody has said I am locked at my native during portfolio submission. Whatever I had on my mobile, I have said, don't worry. Please give EDAT nicely. Please solve those problem solving questions nicely. And the purpose is to see creative inclination. So don't worry, we have a team of around 60 faculty members who will go through all these portfolios and questions, and they will handle it carefully. So don't worry about that. About Mac, I have told it's my experience. So check how to run Windows on Mac, and that will solve the problem. If I finish MCQ portion on the exam early, can I start with problem solving? you can, if you have received the mail. Otherwise, you can start it at 11:30. I am not able to download admit card. I will not answer these questions. Please contact admission section. All those numbers are working and they will help you. About cutoff marks, as I said, there are no cutoff marks, but there is cutoff number. As I said, for UG, BDS, non-fashion, we might select 800 students for second round. For fashion, we might select 300 students for second round. And for masters, in total, we may select 350. Domicile and all, please contact the admission office. They will solve your problem, because we may not be very critical about domicile. But you'll have to contact admission office. I don't want to get into that domain. But we may give certain concession to domicile, but we may not give any concession to caste certificate. If you want to apply under reservation, the caste certificate has to be there. And if it is not there, you automatically go to open. In certain castes, the creamy layer, non-creamy layer conditions are there. So please follow that. We will also follow the same. So we'll not compromise on those things. Problem solving assignment, I have explained. What type of questions will be there in that, I have explained. Start and complete date of admission process, I have already explained. Tuition fees, please see the website. Will there be any studio test and interview? We will not conduct studio test and interview. There was one question about NRIs. There are some NRI students and NRI admission process. If they have applied in NRI category, the admission process is different. For foreign nationals also, the admission process is different. But because we are not conducting interviews this time, all of them should give EDAT. We will give certain weightage to EDAT while selecting you. So we'll go through your portfolio, we'll go through your problem solving question, and we'll go through your EDAT. Because this is unprecedented situation, we have changed it a bit. Otherwise, every year we do it separately. But for all foreign national students who have applied under that category, for all NRI students who have applied under that category, all of them will have to give EDAT. So please give EDAT and please follow all the instructions given. There will be mock test. Can we use rough paper? Yes, you can use. What is the overall mark distribution of each test? As I said, 50% weightage is there for EDAT, 25% weightage is there for problem solving questions, 25% weightage is there for the portfolio. About the system requirements, please try to borrow it, but please see that it is there. NRI, I have covered. What is the exact syllabus? I have covered. I have applied under Maharashtra domicile, as I have covered. Mac OS also, I have answered that question. Almost all the questions are same. Yes, someone is saying, will the UCED 2020 score will be considered? No, we don't consider UCED or NID score. That's the reason why we have our own design aptitude test. It's unfortunate that in India, up till now, there is no common entrance exam nationwide for design. But as the number is growing, probably in future, it will happen. But at present, it is not there. So we are going by our own test. So please give EDAT. Don't rely on UCED score. We don't accept UCED score. There will be one more question, I suppose in parents' mind, because NID results are still not out. UCED process is still half done. So what will happen and how? Why should we confirm? I would say please confirm the admission. If you get, please see the refund rules in details before confirming the admission. And that will help you to solve the problem. So we are aware of the fact that few people may get in NID and they might go to NID and they might prefer NID over MIT ID. But if you are getting MIT ID admission, please take the admission and please see the refund rules before taking the admission. A web camera, I don't have. I think web camera is mandatory, because unless there is a camera, the test will not start. I have answered this. What exactly should I study? I think 4 or 5 categories of questions I have explained. So, and you are wise enough to understand it. So please study on the similar lines of NIPT or UCED or NID, I would say. So results and all other things I have mentioned. So on 9th, the test is there. On 11th, the result of EDAT is there. Then shortlisting will happen. And on 17th, the final result will be there. On a scale of 1 to 10, I don't want to answer these questions. It's a design aptitude test. So please prepare for it and be happy. Give it with full confidence. I'm sure you will come out in flying colors. Personal interviews are not being conducted for the reasons explained. Game design future, please contact our faculty members. For any questions related to faculty, related to discipline, I think you can contact the head of the department of that particular discipline. Especially master students might have some questions like who are the faculty members. In fact, all the information is there on the website. If at all there is further question, please see the website. Please contact the head of the department. Mail ID of head of department is there. He or she will be answering that. So how many days required to complete admission process? So I plan to resign my job. This must be from some master student. As I said, we will start mostly on 1st of September. So you plan it accordingly, but detailed schedule will be there. But UGC guidelines say that we should start in on 1st of September. I have made some mistakes while uploading the portfolio. I have not used the naming convention mentioned while uploading the files. Will it be a big problem? If you have mentioned your name, because the file format was given, uploading format was given, your name should be there so that at least we can identify you. Otherwise, you can send a separate mail to admissions. We'll see who is that person and we'll try to figure it out. If required, we'll contact you again. Could you please brief me about evaluation? I have already explained. So this line was, cut off in the morning because we wanted to, go ahead with the test. I think I have covered many, but I can see 123 questions in my question answer this thing. I'll just go through it. If it is possible to address some of it, I'll try to do that. But you were supposed to ask questions well before, but I'll try to see what it is and if it is possible. But I think more or less the questions are same. There is no echo in an echo in voice. I'm sorry for that. I can't help because I'm also doing it from my home. I'm relying on my home Wi-Fi. We all are in unprecedented situation, can't help. Okay, to be on problem solving. No, we don't want webcam to be there for problem solving assignments. We trust you, we are wise enough. See, there will be comparison. We have your portfolio, we have your design aptitude test, we have your problem solving test. We can very easily check your sketching skills. We can very easily compare it to your portfolio. We can very easily compare it to your performance in EDAT. And we will take a wise call. So don't do any malpractice. We trust you and we want to trust our students. But I think you should play a fair game. Does the offline assignment have, I think I have answered this, what materials can be used, colors in the problem solving. Use colors if you are able to scan it properly, or there is no restriction as such. Don't use watercolors because it will take time for drying and all those things. But there is no restriction, and if there is a restriction, it will be mentioned in the question. So please follow the question. I don't want to answer the questions about eligibility. There is, it's not time to answer these questions because the application date is already over. Mock test will be available. Questions be answered based on general knowledge. Mock test, yes, comes in, okay. I cannot tell you what comes under, let's say, personality trained or this or that. I think you should prepare yourself. I am sure there must be some guidance available. If not, you contact someone, but we cannot give the details because otherwise there is no fun in having that test. Okay, internet connection 5 Mbps. See, 5 Mbps speed is necessary so that there will not be any problem. It works on below this thing also, but for successful this thing, it should be 5 Mbps. That's what the system says. How many questions I have answered? Will there be question based on general knowledge? I don't want to answer that. Please be prepared for a good question paper and please answer that. Is there any management quota? We don't have any management quota. Is there only one list for bidders or there are more rounds? Okay, I forgot this, sorry. So there will be first list and there will be waiting list one and waiting list two. So on the same date, on 17th, we'll declare first list as well as waiting list one and waiting list two. For operation of first list, 1 week's time is there. So on 25th of May, we'll start operating waiting list. You will get a call from our admission office that your waiting number has arrived and now you can come and pay the fees. You can also inquire to the admission office about waiting list status. That is being taken care of. So there will be three lists in all. First list, which is confirmed admission. Second list, which is waiting list number one. And third list, which is waiting list number two. So all those lists will be available. For all the questions related to admission, the problems in admit cards and all other things, please contact. And most of the PG students, I'm surprised they are asking questions like, what type of assignment. I think you are matured students. You have applied. You must have studied our website. You must have gone through the mail. My understanding is people have not gone through the mail. So please go through all the mails very carefully. These documents are available on our website also. Paying the fees, I have explained. Once again, I'll repeat. There will be installments. There will be concessions. There will be scholarships, but you'll have to refer to the mail which you get after the admission is confirmed. This information is also available even today on our website. As I said, the fees part remains same. There will be change in the dates. I mean, till this date, this will be the refund. After that, this will be the refund. Those dates will change, will be a little relaxed in those dates. But for UG, it is competitive, it is tough. People generally pay immediately and confirm the admission. Okay. Can you switch a computer or network connectivity in between? Please don't do that. You'll be automatically out of the test. That's the reason why I say use laptop or use a computer with sufficient backup so that it will not be off immediately. Please make provisions because this is unprecedented situation. We don't want to, trouble our students, but we are helpless in this case. That's why these system requirements are there. Fashion design, is there a different question set? Yes, for fashion design, there will be questions which are different. Certainly, yes. You see results on are you not giving weightage to you? No, we are not giving any weightage to USEED score or NID score. Please contact admission office for caste validity, caste certificate, domicile certificate type of queries. I cannot answer question like any question on maths or general current affairs. Please understand it. I have given you broader topics and you should study maximum. That's the idea. If I give you things like 21 most likely questions, then it doesn't make any sense to conduct any test. I would have given you admissions also directly. That is not the idea with which MIT ID works. Mock test paper will be there. I think more or less the questions are same, which I have answered about system requirements. Please go through the document. You will get two more documents, maybe today or tomorrow. Please go through all the documents. And if someone had joined late, I'm sorry. But still, I have repeated most of the things. I think I have repeated most of the questions. I have answered most of the questions. My only, okay, I'll give you a quick background and then we'll conclude. MIT Institute of Design is from 2006, we are there. We have 60 full-time faculty members, a good, 130 acres residential campus. We have 1,000 capacity hostel. There are 1,300 design students, and out of that, around 700 are girls. So it is very safe for girls, don't worry. So, please go through all these information. There is a lot of information available on website. There is a whole series of webinars which we have conducted this year for different disciplines. So if you go to YouTube and check MIT ID webinars, you'll get at least 10-12 webinars wherein most of the doubts are clear. So if you have any further doubt, I think you can please ask all those doubts. There will not be any problem. You can even personally contact any head of the department. So I hope I have covered most of the things. So once again, I'll repeat, on 9th of May, there will be EDAT 10 to 11:30, 11:30 to 1:30, problem solving questions are to be answered. 1:30 to 2:30, those questions are, those answer sheets are to be uploaded. And then you'll have to wait for 11. On 11, the result of first round will be there. Shortlisted candidates will go to second round, will evaluate their portfolios and their problem solving assignment. And the final result, along with all the processes followed, that means quota, reservation, this, that, all the processes followed, will declare the final result on 17th. So this is in short, and as I said, this process is for MIT Institute of Design, Lodi Karbar, Pune, and Avantika University, Ujjain. Avantika University, after the first round result is declared, will have their independent process. MIT Institute of Design will have its independent process after first round result is declared. So thanks for joining this webinar. And even if there are further questions, you can contact admission team. But on 5th and 6th, be ready for your installation thing. And you can give mock test on 5th and 6th of May, so that you'll be ready for the EDAT on 9th of May. Once again, thank you very much for joining this webinar. And I understand that we all are going through a very difficult situation and times. So this is the best possible option which we could find out for selecting the next batch of MIT Institute of Design. All the best for your career, your EDAT, and for the process. But most important, don't gather at any place. Please follow all the instructions given by central government and state government. Please follow all the instructions given by civic authorities and police department. And even for this test also, don't gather at any place. Give it at your home, at your residence. Thanks a lot. Thank you all. Namaskar.